Hello everyone, we're back to take another look at the elimination method for solving systems of equations. Last time we just looked at equations that were set up already for solving systems by elimination, meaning we had like x and negative x, or 2y and negative 2y. So what if that's not the case? You know, this kind of the simplest example would just be something like this. What if I had x plus 2y is equal to 7? And then what if I had x plus 3y is equal to 9? Okay. So I do have x and x, but if I add x and x together, so if I'm using this, you know, solving by elimination, I'm going to add my two equations together. If I do that here, then x plus x is 2x, and 2y plus 3y is 5y. So this isn't really going to help me. I still do get, you know, the combination of these two equations, but it's not very meaningful right now. It's not helping me solve for where x or y is. Now, if you think kind of graphically, if we had like two lines, I'm going to just really, really oversimplify, but let's just say we had these two lines. By adding them together, we've just kind of made like a third line up here. It's not particularly meaningful. So instead, what we want to do, and kind of undo all of this stuff, is set up the equations first so that they will eliminate. So before I add these together, I want to do something to one of the equations to make it eliminate. And what I can do in this case is I could multiply the top equation by negative 1 on both sides. So I'm multiplying the equation by the same thing on both sides, and all that allows me to do is create an equation where I know the only thing I'm looking at is x. I know I'm going to end up with a negative x in this equation. And that's kind of like what's important to me here, is that negative x, because the second equation has a positive x. I could also do this with y, but it would be a little harder to get 2y and 3y to line up as additive inverses, to line up where adding them together is going to eliminate one of them. You might think about how you would do that, and we'll certainly get into that. What I like to do here when I multiply is just rewrite the equation kind of below here. So I'm going to write negative x, because negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times 2y is negative 2y. And on the other side, I now have negative 1 times 7, which is negative 7. Now if I add these together, x minus x is 0, and that eliminates. That's kind of our whole goal when we're solving systems by elimination. 3y minus 2y is just y, positive y, and 9 minus 7 is 2. Remember, I'm not done. I found out what y is, but let's go back. We can go back to any version of these equations and plug in y equals 2 to find x. So let's go back to this one. X plus 2y equals 7. If x plus 2 times 2 equals 7, it's the same thing as saying x plus 4 equals 7. And if we subtract 4 from both sides, we would see x equals 3. And so this is my answer here. Could write it as an ordered pair, 3, 2. Always write the x first. So the first step to elimination is just thinking to yourself, what do I need to multiply this one of these equations by in order to get the variables to line up so that one can eliminate? Remember, you can multiply them to anything you want. You typically are going to look for the simplest thing first.